All right, greetings, viewers. Welcome to 2021. It was a hard year getting this far, but you made it. And that's something to be proud of, especially this year, when this year was so much harder than a lot of other years. But hey, I'm still willing to put forth some effort and give some entertainment to you guys, and you know, that could be valuable today, it could be valuable several years in the future, and I genuinely hope that you guys enjoy watching these videos, because I enjoy making them too. It's a lot of work sometimes, but it's a way of kind of sharing, well, what I think, but also sharing gameplay with you guys, and, you know, taking comments. I really enjoy reading the comments that any of you write on the channel. Alright, well, here we go. We might as well edit this list live. I've got some ideas about this ahead of time, but the rest of this is going to be kind of improvised as it usually is. So, Deadly Rooms of Death. Obviously, big news with that I announced this year, which was that Treacle Stew, Smite Master's Selection. I am certainly hoping to get that done this year. I can't promise any particular date. I'd certainly like to get this done relatively soon. You know, my dream date would be April 1st, which is the traditional April Fool's release of Caravelle Games, but we'll see. I can't make any promises. It's all going to depend upon a lot of factors that are somewhat out of my control. Not entirely out of my control, but somewhat. I still have a lot of voice acting work to put in the hold, and I'll have to coordinate with Mike Reimer the Steam release of that, and getting perhaps even some cover art commissioned for that, which would be nice. But that's coming along. So, how that relates to this channel is I'm considering doing some developer's commentary on that hold after it is released. Probably a couple of weeks afterwards, probably just to give people some time to actually play it for themselves and form their own opinions and, of course, solve all the rooms. But I think it would still be valuable, of course, because it's always valuable to have a window into what we were thinking at the time. Now, this hold is a little bit unusual in that I created it about 2 years ago. I created it in between Pickle Cellar and Time After Time. Time After Time was actually meant to be like a small, well, relatively small hold to give me a break from working on this thing, but that's just kind of how it turned out, was that this thing wasn't quite done, because it needed a lot more work on it still. The hold itself was done, but it needed more polishing to become a Smite Master selection, as it turned out. There will be a lot to talk about with that. Anyway, these holds, still very much possible coming up in the future, as is this. Stalwart Defense, I think I left that down at the bottom because it was harder than normal, but you know what, I'll bring that up to the top, because I think there was some vague interest in having me work through this, at least when I brought this up at the time, which I think was several months ago. Swarm of Monsters, also horde-based. These all very much horde-based. This one's more of a puzzle hold. This one is, I think it was mostly puzzle with some horde mixed into it, and I think it was short. Yeah, so this one is short. This one's one level. This one is one level. Let's just go ahead and add that in there. One level. Small. I forget how many levels this is. This was multiple levels. This is long, and this is one level. Anyway, so, yeah, any or all of these could show up in this upcoming year. Again, all based upon time I have available, and definitely based upon level of interest shown. Any of these could jump the queue, and your favorite hold could definitely show up here and jump the queue and go up here. But this is probably something I'll do, well, when it's ready. And if anybody wants to hear about anything, any of my other holds, they want me to do developer commentary on those, I could probably manage as well, although they would certainly be even further in the past. But hey, having a source of all the intended solutions all in one collection can be nice too. Yeah, Drought RPG. I mean, it's a great game. It takes a lot of effort to do bookkeeping on it, and I kind of wish that I could have done a Drought RPG series in 2020, but again, it's all about the level of energy that I have available, time, and just prioritization. But I am still interested in following up on this, because I think it's good to document that kind of thing. And it'll be interesting to see if anything changes with regards to the latest patches. I think most of the core, like, mechanics certainly have not changed. I think most of the bug fixes for that are things like rendering issues and maybe some small scripting improvements. So that might not really show up in any of these holds, but maybe some hypothetical future hold might take advantage of the new scripting, and that might be worth taking a look at in the future. So watch this space, I guess. And FTL Faster Than Light, still probably going to be mostly working on this mod pack. Again, I don't really have any obligation necessarily to finish it, but it would be nice. It gives me something to work on that's unusual. Like, all the 28 vanilla ships in FTL Faster Than Light have been done to death at the moment, and there's been so much written about them, so much about how to play with them, how to make them work, what their relative rankings are as far as ease to win, if you're targeting your win rate on, like, a win streak or something. There's just been a lot that's been written about them, but there haven't been a lot of review series like this one that I'm trying to do, which is, like, a pack of 28 ships that are intended to be, like, mirror universe, parallel universe versions of the main ships. And, you know, how are we going to compare them to the main ones? How are we going to rank them amongst themselves? What kind of unique problems could they run into? That's the sort of thing that I'm mostly interested in for this, because it's so, I feel like the core gameplay for this has been, because this has been out for so long, it's kind of been settled almost. Like, there's still micro-optimizations to be made with, especially the Stealth B technology with, weapons timing and the sensors and really ruthlessly exploiting hard mode targeting priorities. And I realize for those of you who have been working on these series that, like, this stuff might not make any sense, but, well, it's kind of the other way around for this, so that's the nature of the thing. But I certainly wouldn't mind taking a break. If anybody's interested in any of these, then I could do this. We could even put in, like, a challenge run for main game ships. One engine run. Because as much as I like to say that engines are overrated, I mean, I don't think I ever did this, if I remember right. That's something I'd have to check on later. But that's something that Dark Twinge did once on a stream with, I think it was like Lanius A or something, so I could pick some other ship and try that out. And then there's these, the randomized player ship and the randomized flagship. If I did that, I'd probably put flagship up here, since of course what I've kind of painted myself into a corner with is changing the player ship, the starting conditions, so to say, and then kind of taking those separate starting conditions through, quote, the same game. So changing the ending condition could be a nice twist on of events. And then, of course, there's Into the Breach, which I did some series on, and I might do other videos on, maybe, like, randomized squads or something, but that's kind of not quite in the same category, because A, it hasn't been out as long, and B, I don't feel like the last word has been written on that quite as much, since there's so much tactical complexity in that. I mean, certainly there is in this, too, but it's been studied for longer, I guess, is what I'm saying. Yeah, puzzle games. Still something I'm really interested in. I've been playing a lot of them recently, like, especially in the Christmas season, and it's been really relaxing to just play them and not have to commentate over them, just play them at my own pace, pause whenever I want to, play whatever sessions I want, but I still feel like that's going to be a core part of this channel as well, just doing, like, not so much, like, the attraction isn't necessarily the showing off of the puzzle game itself, although I certainly try and show my appreciation whenever I can, but I try and explain, like, what I'm thinking. That's what I'm trying to do here. But I also try and talk about, I guess, general puzzle-solving techniques that are applicable not just to the current puzzle that I'm working on, but also in general. That's kind of the attitude I'm trying to get at, but I don't know necessarily how well I always succeed at that. But these and more certainly are all possibly on the list. I actually forgot about this one. I should probably try and make an effort for that, because I think this came up like about a year ago. Yeah. So, anyway. I think at the time, yeah, from last year, I think I said I wasn't interested in Opus Magnum because Alex Steiner was doing an LP of that. Well, that was a year ago, so that doesn't apply anymore. Of the Zachtronix games, I'd probably be most interested in playing that at the moment because my day job is as a programmer for a financial services company. So I do front-end web development. So that involves a lot of typing and a lot of looking at text. So that makes... I'm not so interested in playing TIS 100 or Shenzhen IO, which would be down here. No, it's not down here. I don't have... Oh, here it is. Yeah, programming games. So, yeah, I'm not quite as interested in these currently, although certainly anything that's graphical or anything that has, like, a twist on it, like maybe Hacknet, would be a little bit more interesting than just typing a whole bunch of text into a terminal and compiling it, because I certainly have enough of that for my day job. Right. Well, I was about to follow that up with something else, but I think I lost it, so we'll just go back up here. Yeah, so expect the unexpected, I guess. I mean, certainly I'll take whatever suggestions you have, but I am interested in... Oh, yeah, here we go. Recursed. This one is like a... I'll probably link to this in the description or something, but this is like a platformer where the... there's boxes in the rooms, but the boxes contain other rooms inside of them, and you can be all recursive because you can take a box outside of its own level or something. It's been a while since I looked at the trailer for that, but that could be neat. So that's potentially on the list. I guess I'll just kind of wedge it in here, maybe. Maybe put this over here. I don't know. This is obviously not a very formal order, but... I'll just kind of leave it like that as a note to myself, maybe. So programming games, potentially on the list, but I probably wouldn't count on Shenzhen IO in particular. Like, these probably, maybe more towards the end of the year. It's all gonna depend upon a lot of timing of a lot of other things with my personal life. But, I don't know. It's, like this is long. Things like this are short, because, this is like a, if it's anything like Uplink was, this would be like a long, continuous campaign where I'd have to, like, probably, like, simulate, like, a week's worth of in-game time or half an hour or something, and, the campaign would take a long time, whereas something like this is kind of more, like, level-based, so there's more individual breakpoints. Sure, we'll go with that. Anyway, so we'll keep going down the list. Crypt of the Necrodancer, probably I'm just going to go ahead and delete that. I mean, it's a game that I'm interested in, but I don't think I really have much to offer on that myself, specifically, is kind of how I feel about that. It's another one of those games that's both kind of like FTL, almost. It's been studied almost to death. And the more you look at it, the more you realize that it's really propped up by a lot of really weird spaghetti code. And there's, like, the more you look at it, there's more, like, non-beatmap-based animation stuff. And I kind of hit the limit of my own skill on that game, too. So I just, there's not really that much I can really demonstrate on that, I feel. I mean, I'd certainly, if there's, like, fans of that game who really want to see me specifically play the game and post-commentate on it or add subtitles, then I would probably give that at least a fair shake, but, you know, prioritization. I mean, look at all this. This is all from last year. This is all, like, not even taking into account anything that happened this year. And, you know, the entire point of prioritization is being able to point at certain items on the list and say, okay, you know what? I'm not gonna play these. And that's fine. That is all well and normal. So yeah, Teleglitch and Rogue Legacy, you know, you guys are out of here. I think I still kind of play them a little bit on my own time, but, you know, I think it's about time to move on as well. So we'll try and pay some attention to something that I feel will be worthwhile. I mean worthwhile both, not just in a catering to the audience sense, but also worthwhile in a I'm going to have fun playing this myself sense because it's going to be novel. That kind of thing. You know, the... How do I say this? Time marches on. Or not just time, but culture marches on. Yeah, that kind of thing. Oh boy, art school. I'm sorry, folks. I did kind of want to play more of this, but it's... I kind of feel like I'm almost too emotionally invested in that game, because I really want to portray, like, some effort in the amount of art that I do. It's obviously not, it's not my forte in terms of the fact that I don't practice it that often for fun. Yeah, that's a good way of phrasing that. This isn't something that I would play on my own time, because I... Like, it's a good break from all this stuff up here, but it's just not something that I spend my spare time doing. I'm not the kind of kid who, sketched in the margins of his sketchbook. I mean, I like art. I like art a lot, and I like producing art. It's always so fun to see when it's done, but it's, you know, all artists struggle with this. It's, like, the actual process of producing art is, like, trying to force a rock through a sieve. It's tough. But, hey, it's rewarding, and I do want to see this through. I hope that I can, you know, return to this and get some regularly timely things on this. I might just have to put, like, a schedule on this. Like, maybe do one of these every Wednesday night or something. One drawing. Because I'm interested in the plot of this, too. I mean, it's kind of 50-50 on whether there even is going to be a plot, if the professor is just going to give me encouraging commentary and you just have 50 prompts and that's it. That's all the plot you get. But it definitely seems like the kind of thing where the plot could kind of sneak up on you when you least expect it. And I've not gotten very far in this yet at all, so there's still time for that. This is also kind of a weird category, too. I mean, I actually have something in mind for this. I'm just going to go ahead and say that the mystery game is in here. I'm still working out how to record it properly. And if I can't record it properly, then of course the nice thing about calling it the mystery game is that I can always change my mind as to what the mystery game is. I can claim all along that, oh, the new mystery game is actually what the mystery game was. Actually, I'm just going to go ahead and give you a hint. It's on the NES. So there you go. And that's a footnote, so don't need that anymore. Yeah, so I'll keep my cards close to my chest on that one, and we'll go from there. Right, and then the things I need better computer for? Yeah, let's talk about this. Initially, our plan was to get a better computer around Christmas time, which would probably be like a... probably just a Windows 10 desktop model. But we're doing a lot of... Not home remodeling, but home reshuffling, I guess. We're moving stuff around from room to room. So... And Christmas time isn't really a great time to go computer shopping either, because there's so much demand for computer parts and pre-built ones. So probably my plan for this is to probably get a new computer probably around March or April or something. And it'll be around then when I should be able to run these and emulate these and record them. So given like all this stuff up here, probably I wouldn't expect anything like this until the end of the year, like the latter half of the year. Still potentially in the list. Like it's the whole point of this is just something I can refer to later. But stay patient on these. These are probably not going to be coming in the near future, is I guess what I'm saying. So yeah, a lot to look forward to this year. And again, like I said, this is a hobbyist hobby, and I certainly only do this when I feel like it. So definitely, like, any random set of these things will come out when they're ready. So... thank you for being patient, and thank you for staying with me, and I certainly hope to keep this channel going, through easy times and through hard. So, I'll see you for whatever the next project is lined up.